Hola, ¿qué tal amigos? ¿Cómo están? En unas historias hace un par de semanas les contaba un poco del proyecto de Llave, de Llave World. Bueno, la gente de Llave me puso en contacto con Frederick Chesnais. Frederick es el CEO de Atari. La verdad que no quise perderme la oportunidad de entrevistarlo, si bien él habla inglés, me las arreglé y logré una entrevista y quería compartirles un poco la visión que él tenía de todo lo que se viene en el mundo gaming. Ustedes saben que Atari y todas sus compañías están trabajando mucho en lo que es mundo gaming, NFTs, con mundo blockchain, con un poco de realidad virtual, conectar estos universos que hay hoy en el mundo gaming entre sí. Hay muchos proyectos que está bueno que se conecten. Él nos cuenta un poco de eso en la entrevista. Me parece súper interesante ver la visión y entender cómo lo ven los grosos de la industria. Así que vamos a las pantallas y les cuento qué nos dijo.
So first of all, thank you very much for your time. I know you are pretty busy nowadays, so thanks a lot. The people of Llave made me the contact with you, and we wanted to make some questions about how do you see nowadays the cryptocurrency ecosystem, and then we're probably going to go a little bit deeper on the metaverse and Alphaverse you're working on. So first of all, how do you see the cryptocurrency nowadays ecosystem pushing? What's your point of view about it?
I think, you know, at the end of the day, it comes down to blockchain. So what's very interesting these days is, you know, if you look at the landscape 1 year ago, you mainly had Ethereum. But now you can see a lot of, you know, new blockchains making their way, proposing new applications. I think, I don't want to name any of those, but the good thing is that you have more options today. And as a consequence, you know, when you issue a token, if you look at the Atari token, for instance, you have to really think cross-platform. So this is why, for instance, the Atari token is on Ethereum, but it's also on Phantom, it's also on Binance. We are working on additional ports. So I think for me, everything comes down to, okay, where is blockchain going? And I think blockchain is going in the right direction. And then the cryptos, the cryptocurrencies will just follow.
Okay. And you see, you mentioned different blockchains and different cryptocurrencies. You see in a future, or even it's happening right now, but you see more connectivity between blockchains as well?
But I don't know. I think everyone wants to have their own, you know, so to say, expertise, their own selling point. So I don't think so. I think it's going to be different. They will not be compatible. I think the compatibility will be with the crypto currencies. But at the end of the day, you know, it's just going to be, you're not going to have 20 successful blockchain platforms, right? You're going to have, I don't know, a limited number of them, but not 20, not 50, not 100, I think, because people think about, you know, you have Microsoft, you have Apple, so these are the two dominant systems, right? With, of course, Android after that. It's going to be, I think, like this. It will likely come down to a limit. I don't want to give you a number, but it's going to be a limited number of blockchain platforms.
Yeah, totally agree. Just thinking about movies like Ready Player One or Blade Runner and Atari, that was very emblematic on those movies. Thinking about the virtual reality and how do we see the gaming ecosystem? What is your future thinking for the blockchains combining with this virtual reality world?
What's interesting with blockchain, you know, because it offers a unique way or a new way, which is very interesting to play, because that's its collectability, transparency, you know, exactly how many cards are out there. When you buy something, you can reuse it somewhere else, you can sell it, you can keep it, trade it. So I think blockchain is bringing a lot of authenticity and security and transparency to the gaming space. Not all the games will be on the blockchain. Not every transaction in the game will be on the blockchain, but I think you can have like a very nice combination of a gaming unity with a very successful blockchain layer. And I think this is what we're working on.
Yeah, I totally agree on on-chain transactions and off-chain transactions combined in the gaming experience. Right, totally right. And how do you see art and music falling in this new ecosystem? Because now with the NFTs, and there's a lot of art and music, right?
I think we will need to have like a broader experience for art, a broader experience for music. So that's why I'm working on the, you know, metaverse. The times where, you know, you would buy a piece of art, you would just keep it. I think it's interesting, but players will want more. So one way to deliver more to the players is to tell them, look, if you have it, that piece of art, that photo, when you join that metaverse, you can have a house in which you can see your photo. So being able to share, to show off, so we say your trophies and what you have is interesting. It's the same with music. You know, you could be, you could own a music NFT. Is it a video? Is it a photo of an artist? Is it whatever it is? But at the end of the day, it's going to be interesting to be able to use these NFTs in a metaverse. That's at least that's what I think.
I totally agree, and this will, I think, will change the way we work and the way we commerce in the future, probably in this metaverse. You mentioned your work in your company in CVI on Alphaverse and Metaverse. You want to tell us a little bit more about that development?
Yeah, sure. We're going to, so there's already a Telegram group, Alphaverse Game. There's also a Twitter account, Alphaverse Game. So we're about to announce in October some pre-sales and what the world is about. So you should be able to learn more, but it's basically a virtual world where I'm trying to aggregate as many universes as possible. So Chavi is one of them, but also I have my own universes. So think about a main place, a hub, and from the hub, you can join a different universe to have a different experience. But you have, it's like a set of TV channels. You have maybe 100, 200, 500 channels as a plan.
So this will connect different universes, let's say different metaverses through your alphabet.
Yes.
Great. And how do you see that interaction between the Xavi world metaverse and the rest of the metaverse that will combine over there?
I think, at the end of the day, players want to have a broad experience and they want to have a seamless experience, right? So being able to join a game, join a world, and then move from experience A to experience B, from music to art to zombie games, shooting games, racing games. I think that's what I'm trying to achieve. And it's of course very, very difficult to have all these experiences with the same game engine or with the same on the same blockchain platform. So this is why using that, that gimmick of the connection, people understand that yes, we are moving from the hub to a different universe, and they accept it for 2-3 seconds. But it makes sense, and this is what we're trying to achieve.
Yeah, I know Xavi World is more like if music. At least it started with music, so. The user could have an experience in that world and then move to another metaverse to have a gaming experience, for example.
Yeah, the idea is to have like a single username. You just reactivate or reconfirm your password. But the whole point is to basically have a consolidated database of usernames. So if I join a new world, my username is already available. So we basically reserve them. That's the idea, yes.
And are you expecting in Xavi World or in the other metaverse to have, besides of the entertaining and gaming features, to have more like financial features like farming or staking or play to earn, for example?
Yes, I think this is part of the blockchain. This is what players are looking for. So yes, the short answer is yes. Play to earn, city building, farming, all of that, yes. It takes time.
Very good point. What time do you think we need in order to our population to adopt this technology? Because it's in terms of adoption, right?
Well, I think it's already here, right? But what's going to happen, I think, it's going to take time. And at the same time, you're going to see a lot of applications in some fields like insurance, finance, of course. But insurance, I see a lot of opportunities in insurance policies, being paid off right away. If something happens, you don't have to file a claim. You don't have to wait. You just, the event happens, you're paid, done. So I think there's a lot of additional opportunities outside of the gaming space. I mean, finance, gaming, these are obviously the first ones, but as I've said, insurance. You will see a lot of things also in like every social network, being able to verify, okay, this guy is not a robot, that girl is not, she's really what she says she is. I think you will see a lot of new applications like these ones.
That's kind of the digital identity or social media digital identity joining the metaverse or joining this blockchain system. That's very interesting. I saw a lot of people talking about being owner of your own data to allow to share what information we're going to share with who. So I think that's very, very interesting. And that will happen in the metaverse as well, I'm sure about that. What's what you like more about these virtual reality projects? I'm pretty fan of the virtual reality gaming, but what do you like, what do you prefer of these worlds?
I think virtual reality will come, but at a later stage. I think what's very interesting these days is city building, collecting, farming. I think this is really this is what I like to do, but I think this is a natural way. This is a natural entry point for the players, And then, you know, as the technology evolves, you're going to see more applications, you're going to see more opportunities, you're going to see, you know, more ways to play. So we wait, you know, look, if you look at the history of video games, not even going back to 1972, but if you just go back to PlayStation 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, Xbox, da-da-da, then you have the Switch. So it's here to stay.
Yeah, step by step. Yeah, I know. I'm kind of always enthusiastic by the future. So, but I believe, as you mentioned, building cities, farming, creating your own art and music as well, will be great. Anything else you want to tell us about your projects, about CBI and what you're building?
Pretty soon, check it out. For the Atari token, there will be some special gifts. There will be some special, you know, flats, buildings, and some special elements. But at the end of the day, just the beginning. So, you know, it's going to be an ever-evolving world. It's the same, by the way, in video game space today. You know, when you look at games, they are released. We have invested, let's say, 100 in the game until the release date, and you invest 500, 10 times more after the release. So this is what gamers also have to understand. It takes time, and the games do evolve over time. I'm not going to mention any name in particular, but I see games that I have released in 2017. They're still around, and they have much more content. So, you know, it's pretty cool.
And you mentioned gamers. Gamers, some years ago, were hiding people. Now they are putting in the front of all these ecosystems. So gamers are very, very strong players nowadays.
Again, it takes time. You know, I think the average player today is, what, 37, 39 years old. And on Candy Crush, is a woman. So you still have a lot of the population that is not playing. So we still have to wait. But, you know, as time goes by, you're going to see more players coming from different countries because now they're going to get an internet connection. They will never buy the PlayStation 5, right? But they will have an internet connection, so they will be able to play on PC or on phones, especially on phones. And because, you know, the performance and technical specification of the phones today, we are much stronger than the laptops we had in 2000, 2006, 2010. So that shows also that there's a lot of tech. It's always a balance to be found between the tech, the experience. But at the end of the day, you're going to see more players coming, more players. Look at Indonesia, you know. It was not on the map a few years ago. Thailand was on the map a few years ago. It was new. Yeah, it's obvious. Indonesia, I see a lot of players coming from Indonesia, and they spend money, they play. It's fun interacting with them.
Yeah, now they are rocking. Yeah, totally agree.
Yeah, but you know, seen from a perspective in Europe or in South America, you're like, no, but yeah, they're coming.
They are coming for sure. So we are going to share in the video comments the link on the Atari token, the CVI projects you mentioned, of course, of Shabby World, all these initiatives and development. So if our audience finds some airdrops and can join early this stage, I think that would be great for all of us.
That's great. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for the opportunity.
Let's keep pushing for this new and for these innovations.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Okay. Thanks.
Bueno, espero que les haya gustado. Siempre es bueno entender cómo lo ven los líderes de la industria. Les voy a dejar, como siempre, los links de los mundos que hablamos, ¿no? Shabby World, de lo que hablamos de Atari Token también. Se los dejo todos acá abajo. Espero que les haya gustado. Ya voy a hacer otros videos contando todos los proyectos en los que yo estoy prestando atención en el mundo de gaming, NFTs y metaversos. Me parece que hay un abanico grande, uno no puede prestar atención a todos, pero sí hay 4 o 5 que yo estoy siguiendo de cerca para ver, tratar de agarrarlos antes de que lancen. También hay otros como que ya les vengo comentando, como Axie y demás, en los que ya estoy metido. Pero los que vienen son los que más me interesan porque uno trata de entrar a tiempo, ¿no? Antes. Si bien este video fue medio complicado por el tema del inglés y los subtítulos, espero que les haya gustado. Si valoran este tipo de esfuerzo, por favor, déjenme un like, denme un comentario. Cuéntenme de otros proyectos que ustedes sepan que están analizando, a ver si logramos poder contactar a las personas que están del otro lado y también sumar un poco más de ideas. Está bueno entender qué cosas vienen y que nos vayan contando y estar al día con los últimos lanzamientos. Déjenme un like y también comenten, porque voy a estar haciendo un sorteo sobre los comentarios de los últimos videos, probablemente este y el próximo. Vamos a estar sorteando bonos de Bing Bong y también vamos a estar sorteando Cars, es decir, los autitos del juego de gaming que te permite jugar y es un play to earn que vas ganando. Síganme también en Instagram para estar actualizados, ahí es donde posteo más frecuentemente y nos vemos en el próximo video. Muchas gracias.